What we're going to do here is derive the binomial series formula, which is another way to expand out functions. And the way we develop the formula is we take this form, because this is the form that we're going to expand to the binomial series, 1 plus x, binomial, two terms, to the p power. So we're going to find the Taylor series at x equals 0 of this function. So we do our normal derivatives. So we see a pattern. Evaluate at x equals 0. Here's what you're going to get. Okay. Then the coefficients, the ck, are going to be those values with that pattern. Notice that it goes to p minus 1, and that's a 2 up there. P minus 2, and that's a 3 up there. So it goes to p minus 1 less than the k. Starts at p and multiplies down to that. So 1 plus x to the p is this pattern right here. These coefficients, each time multiplying p minus 1 less than the power, and you got your k factorial on the bottom. So that's what it is, binomial series is. And we'll just clean that up a little bit, and here it is right here. That's the way you normally use it. But it's also equivalent to this right here. That's using the pattern. Can't start at k equals 0 on this form, because k equals 0 makes this be p plus 1, and that doesn't work out with what we have up here. But that's okay. So the question is, where does it converge? And we'll see that below. So we won't worry about that yet. So here's an example. Expand out 1 over 1 plus x squared. We're going to use the binomial series. But first, we go into Wolfram Alpha and find out that the series expansion using Taylor is this. So let's see if expanding this as a binomial series gives the same answer. So to write it in binomial series form, it'd be 1 plus x to the p. And p is negative 2. So you just plug in the p. 1 plus negative 2x plus negative 2 times negative 2 minus 1. There's your negative 3. P minus 1, p minus 2. P is negative 2. P minus 1, negative 3. P minus 2, negative 4. And there's your exponents. So this is what you have. Then all you have to do is clean it up and you get this, which does match up exactly to this right here. We had it out this far. Okay, so it's working. So the idea is, if you can spot these special ones that happen to be able to be expanded by rewriting this way in a binomial form, then you can use a binomial series because it's a lot faster. Notice we didn't have to go through any derivatives to do this example. We just wrote down with the formula. Here's another example. This time we have 1 over square root of 1 plus x. We're going to expand it about 0. When you do that with the Taylor series, you get out of Wolfram Alpha this right here. Okay, but that would require taking all those derivatives and figuring out the ck and then plugging it in. So let's just see what we can do with the binomial series for the same function, because we realize that you can rewrite it as 1 plus x to the negative 1 half. That's 1 plus x to the p. So we just match it up to the formula and then plug everything in. P is negative 1 half, negative 1 half, negative 1 half minus 1 is negative 3 halves, negative 1 half, negative 3 halves, negative 3 halves minus 2, or I'm sorry, negative 1 half minus 2, negative 5 halves. So then simplify that out. And you get this, simplify that last number here. You get this, and that matches up exactly to Wolfram Alpha. We did these terms right here. So it all works out. So the binomial series is working. For what values of x does the binomial series converge? We were interested in that before. So 1 plus x to the p equals 1 plus the k equal 1 to infinity series that we had. So we just want to see if this series converges or not, because if it does, then adding 1 won't affect it. And if it doesn't, adding 1 won't affect that either. So we use the ratio test. Here's your ratio test on the terms. Simplify it all down. Right here, the number in the multiplication right before you get to p minus k is to p minus k plus 1. 1 higher than p minus k. See, right there. And then you can see that all this stuff cancels out. All cancels out, and you just get this. The k plus 1 factorial is a trick we always use. It's k plus 1 times the rest of them, k factorial equals this. Divide k plus 1 into each one of these. Now take the limit as k goes to infinity. The p is just a constant no matter what it is, so that part's going to go to 0. So this part, I factor out the x. So that part goes to 0. This part goes to negative 1, but its absolute value goes to absolute value of x. For convergence, we need that to be less than 1. So this is your interval of convergence. Okay. Now, it's interesting, and we'll talk about this in the next video.